Around 8 months after announcing its intention to do so, NASA has awarded SpaceX a contract for a second crewed Starship Moon landing, as early as 2027. Join us as we bring you, SpaceX and NASA finalize contract for second crewed Starship Moon landing, NASA successfully launch SLS rocket for the first time. Known as Option B, NASA has exercised a baked-in right to modify its human landing system, option a contract with SpaceX, signed in April 2021 to extract even more value from investments into the program. In addition to an uncrewed Starship Moon landing planned no earlier than 2024, and a crewed demonstration that could land two NASA astronauts on the Moon, as early as 2025. NASA's contract modification gives SpaceX the approval and resources it needs to prepare for a second crewed Starship Moon landing. On top of securing NASA's Artemis 3 mission astronauts a ride to the lunar surface. The Option B contract will also allow SpaceX and NASA to pursue and demonstrate upgrades that will make Starship an even more capable and cost-effective moon lander. When NASA first announced its intention to add a second crewed moon landing to SpaceX's existing HLS contract, the agency couldn't offer specific information about when that landing might occur, or which Artemis mission it would be attached to. Part of the reason for that uncertainty was another announcement 2 months prior, that NASA no longer expected a moon landing to be paired with its Artemis 4 mission. And 5 days after a March 2022 announcement of plans for a second crewed Starship moon landing, NASA seemingly reaffirmed that there would be a multi-year gap between Starship's first crewed moon landing 2025. Tied to Artemis 3, and NASA's second crewed moon landing, which would use an unspecified lander. But as of November 2022, NASA has thankfully abandoned plans to intentionally allow a gap between moon landings. SpaceX's Starship is now on contract to support back-to-back crewed moon landings 2025 and 2027, as part of NASA's Artemis 3 and Artemis IV missions. It's unclear how or why NASA was able to make that change, but it's a definite improvement over the alternative. Additionally, NASA will work with SpaceX to debut new capabilities and improvements on Starship's second crewed moon landing. While the Artemis 3 landing will be about as bare-bones as possible, the Artemis 4 Starship will be upgraded with the ability to transport more NASA astronauts, 4 instead of just 2, and more cargo to the lunar surface. It's not entirely clear, but NASA reportedly wants to land just approximately 180 kilograms, approximately 400 pounds of cargo with the first crewed Starship. A vehicle likely capable of landing dozens of tons of cargo, in addition to several astronauts. NASA hopes that future, sustainable, lander missions, a category that Starship's Option B landing may or may not fall under, will transport up to 1 ton of cargo to and from the lunar surface. Finally, the Artemis 4 Starship will also be able to dock with NASA's Lunar Gateway. Gateway is a small deep space station that will be located in a strange, high lunar orbit. It exists almost exclusively to give NASA's Space Launch System rocket and Orion crew capsule a destination they can both reach. The Orion capsule is almost twice as heavy as its Apollo counterpart, and its European service module offers less than half the performance of NASA's retired Apollo service module. Combined, Orion is physically incapable of transporting itself, or astronauts, to the simpler low lunar orbits used by the Apollo program. Instead, NASA's new moon lander have to pick up Orion's slack. Starship will be responsible for picking up astronauts in a lunar near-rectilinear halo orbit, transporting them to low lunar orbit, and returning them to NRHO in addition to landing on the Moon, spending a week on the surface, and launching back into lunar orbit. Until it's modestly upgraded in the late 2020s or 2030s, Gateway will be equally underwhelming. In fact, that's part of the reason that Starship docking with the Gateway is in any way significant. SpaceX and NASA have decades of expertise docking and berthing spacecraft with space stations. But those spacecraft are typically smaller and lighter than the stations they were joining. Even after the Gateway is fully outfitted with a range of international modules, Starship will likely weigh several times more than the tiny station, making docking even more challenging than it already is. Starship's moon lander variant could also have a cabin with hundreds of cubic meters of habitable space, while the Gateway is unlikely to ever have more than a few dozen. Having a Starship docked would thus immediately make the ultra-cramped station far more livable. NASA says Artemis 4 and the second crew Starship Moon landing will occur as early as 2027. But a space prophet, who predicted in 2017 that NASA's SLS launch debut would slip from 2019 to around 2023, and forecasted that SpaceX alone would win NASA's Moon Lander contract, recently told Ars Technica's Eric Berger that Artemis 3, the mission before Artemis 4, is unlikely to launch before 2028. At the time, that source's predictions verged on blasphemy, but they've ultimately proven to be eerily accurate. Only time will tell if their third prophecy follows the same path. As a result, NASA is watching every step of the development of SpaceX Starship next. It can't be denied that this orbital flight has implications for the entire space industry and our planet. This flight will open the door to orbital tourist flights, which could render the aircraft industry obsolete. It's also one of the goals of SpaceX. They want it to take people from place to place on the planet, making most long-distance trips in less than 30 minutes, and going anywhere around the world in under 1 hour. The space industry will also develop a new leap forward. It's getting closer to the goal of sending humans to the Moon and Mars in the future. If SpaceX succeeds with Starship, it could become a new trend for other companies to develop reusable rockets, to build cheaper rockets and reduce turnaround launch times between flights. With a roar that lit up the night sky, NASA sent its colossal next-generation rocket soaring into space for the first time, on Wednesday. The Space Launch System rocket, or SLS, took off at 1:47 a.m. from Cape Canaveral, Florida, signaling the start of a bold new era for the U.S. government's space program. It also marks a major success for NASA's Artemis program to return to the Moon, which has been plagued by years of delays, development mishaps, and billions of dollars in budget overruns. During the past few months, both hurricanes and technical difficulties caused launch delays, including two scrubs. Then, tonight, engineers managed to fix both an intermittent hydrogen leak and a bad Ethernet switch in the hours just before launch. NASA can now put many of those problems in the rear view as it looks ahead to the program's future. "For the Artemis generation, this is for you," said Charlie Blackwell Thompson, Artemis launch director, as she gave the go-ahead for launch. The SLS carried its Orion capsule to an altitude of just under 4,000 kilometers before the two craft separated and the core stage of the rocket fell back to Earth. Orion will continue onward to the Moon, which it will orbit for several days before returning to Earth. The capsule is scheduled to splash down in the ocean on December 11. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, to make sure you can subscribe. If you have any crazy idea what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we will see if we can get the, and thanks again for watching and goodbye.